today as we give thanks to God. Hallelujah. For all he's done. Oh, we thank you, God. We thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. The Savior of my soul. The Redeemer of my story. Hallelujah. And if you're here to say thank you, come and join us in worship today.
What you're going through, it's time to get up and dance out of those graves. Amen, amen, amen. I think you guys came ready to worship today. I think you guys came ready to worship today. I just want to encourage you guys, just start coming up front. I just want to tell you guys what's on my heart, what's on my mind today. And it's the veil. I was thinking about it this morning. I was thinking about the veil this morning. It was in the temple. The Bible says the veil was the thickness of a man's hand. And it separated the two parts of the temple. And only the high priest could go beyond that veil. And that high priest, he had to be pretty much near perfect just to go in there. And they would tie a rope to him just in case he had a little imperfection. He would get burnt like toast and they would pull him out. And I was just thinking about it this morning. When our Savior endured that horrible death, and when he hung on that cross, and when he said it is finished, the Bible says that veil was torn. But it wasn't just torn from the earthquake. You know, there was an earthquake at the same time, but as you know, when there's an earthquake, it moves foundations and things, they crack from the bottom. But the Bible is very careful to say that the veil was torn from the top down. And the mighty hands of our Savior took that veil and he said, finally, my lovely, my sweet, my bride, finally, you can come into my presence. And this veil that once represented death, which is the transition from this world into the presence of our Savior, death was broken, death was defeated, the veil was broken, and now we get to go into his presence. We get to worship him in that holy place. We get to do it alone. You can do it in your car, but you know what? There is something special about when we get to come together as his bride and we sing in, as one voice in unity, lifting up the King of Kings. And at one point, the offering was essentially an entrance fee. At one point, the offering was something you had to do so that you could be with him. But now the offering is more like a gift that you bring your husband or a gift that you bring your wife. Think of it like an anniversary gift. This is something special that we can bring him anytime just to say, God, we love you. We're thankful for who you are. Thank you for saving me. Thank you for taking me, Lord, from what was miry clay and breathing life into me, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord, because I know where I would be without you, Lord God. Because I know where I've been, Lord Jesus. I know where I would be without you, Lord God, and I never want to be there. I never want to go back. I never want to be the same, Lord Jesus. But I want to spend my days like David, just basking in your presence, Lord God. So Lord Jesus, I pray, Lord God, that as we give you this offering, as we give you this gift, Lord Jesus, as the word says, Lord, that it would be a sweet fragrance to you, Lord Jesus. Lord, that we could come to you, Lord, with clean hearts, with clean hands, Lord Jesus, setting everything aside now, Lord God, setting every worry aside, and we could come to you in faith. Because your word says it's impossible to please you without it. You know, it's impossible to please our Savior without faith. So I want you guys, just come up front. Let's worship him together. The song says, come, let us worship the Lord. Let us bow down before him. His banner is love over us. His mercies are new every morning. Every single morning like manna, he pours out his mercies on us, even though we don't deserve it. He already paid that price. You see, the price has already been paid. There's nothing left that he needs to do. We just need to come to him with faith. Saying, when I worship you, I believe chains will break. Come on. Come on, church. I believe it. When I worship you, I believe chains will break. When I lift my voice, nothing will be the same. I'm gonna let the rocks cry out for me. Oh, you deserve the highest praise. Can we agree on that? He deserves it. You deserve the highest praise. Just sing it out to him. You deserve the highest praise. We're gonna worship you this morning in spirit and in truth. Oh, what we know of you, you reveal in worship. You reveal more of yourself, God. We wanna know more of you. Lord, we wanna know more of you, Lord Jesus. So as we worship you this morning, Lord, in spirit and in truth, Lord God, we worship what we know of you, what we read of you, what we've heard of you, Lord Jesus. But we believe and we come expecting, Lord Jesus, that in your presence, as we worship you, as we bow down before you, you will reveal things to us that we do not know, Lord Jesus. Another aspect of your greatness, of your love, of your mercy, just shower it out on us. We want more, Lord. I don't know about you, but I want more of him. I don't know about you, but I want more of him. I want more of him. Let's give what we have. Let's give our finest. Let's give our first fruit. Let's give our best. For only you are worthy. Only you are worthy. Come, let us worship. Oh, come, let us sing. To the Lord, let us sing. Come, let us bow down before him. His banner is love over us, and his mercies are new. His mercies are new every morning. So we sing, oh. start to worship. Start to lift up your own song. Start to lift up your voice this morning. Deserve it, our highest praise. Cause only you are worthy, only you deserve it, our highest praise. Highest praise. Oh, I believe that veil was torn. That veil was torn, so I could worship. I could be surrounded. so much higher. You're so much higher. You're so much greater. So much greater. Oh, our minds can't even comprehend it. Oh, how great you are. Can't even comprehend it. How great you are. How mighty. How mighty. Sing it this morning. Great are you. Isn't he worthy? Church, isn't he worthy of our highest praises? We were created for this. We were created to worship. We were given free choice. This is a choice. It's a choice to worship. We choose this day and every day the level of our sacrifice and the quality, what we're going to give. Lord, we give you the best. We give you the first, because you are the first, Lord God. You deserve it all. You deserve it.
Pastor Stephen shared my scripture this morning. When he prayed exactly the scripture that God had given me in Matthew 27. And it said, Jesus had cried out again in a loud voice, and he gave up his spirit. And at that moment, the curtain of the temple was torn in two from top to bottom. The earth shook, the rocks split, and the tombs broke open. And the bodies of many holy people who had died were raised to life. They came out of the tombs after Jesus' resurrection and went to the holy city and appeared to many people. That was the scripture that God had gave me this morning, and he prayed that, and then he said it, and I was like, oh, he stole my scripture. But I'm not saying this morning for sympathy, but sometimes Stephen and I come to church on Sundays on like 2 hours of sleep. We both have sleep issues that we're believing God to heal us from. And I texted him last night. I said, I haven't slept in a few days. I'm really struggling. I may not come. And I came this morning and he yelled at me. And he said, stay home and rest. But I can't stop thinking about the veil that was torn. And I don't know about you guys, but there's no place I'd rather be than to be in the sanctuary, whether I've had an hour of sleep, whether I'm sick in my body, whether I have no money, whether I have just anything that I'm facing in my life. I love Sunday. I love the house of God. I love to sit under the word. When Pastor Rob preaches, my soul is restored. I'm full again. And I can leave here knowing that I have all the ammunition I need to fight the enemy that week. And so I don't say that because I want sympathy. I want to say that because what God did for us, we don't have to stand in the outer courts like Pastor Stephen said and wait just for the glory cloud and just stand there behind a curtain. We can go in, and that's our place of refuge. So this morning, as we sing this very simple song, let's consider what's been done at the cross. Let's consider who he is, and let's go in to give him the glory that he deserves. Hallelujah. Let this worship crash the shores of heaven. Let this song storm the heavenly gates. Let us praise your mighty name forever. As I bow before your throne of grace, come on all together. Let this worship crash the shores of heaven. Let the song storm the heavenly gates. Let us praise your mighty name forever. As we bow before your throne of grace, we sing. We sing. We don't care what our worship sounds like this morning. We're making a joyful noise.
Holy is your name.
I don't care.
We sing it.
Holy is your name.
I'm gonna sing
Yahweh,
your praise. All my
days. Holy is your name.
Yahweh.
All
of heaven
resounds. Holy is your name.
King of kings and Lord of lords. Let this worship crash the shore. His throne room. Let this worship crash.
Let this worship crash the shores of heaven. Let this song storm the heavenly gates.
Because you're worthy.
Let us praise your mighty name forever. As we bow before your throne.
Come on, Izzy, prophesy on those keys. Hallelujah.